Thank you, sir. God bless you, gentlemen.
I thank the Lord always for the opportunity. And tell me adult before us warm up, come in for. And that's what I want to talk about in my body to see. That's what that's to me, Christian. And that's what's very important. We're going to talk about witnessing and about winning souls. You see, the whole purpose of us being a Christian is to be a witness. And the reason why we're a witness, we need to save souls. Now, that's John.
Amen.
Let's pray before we begin. Thank you, Mugadil. Father, I thank you, Mugadil, for tonight, Mugadil. And ask Mugadil, Kirchi, Buchiad, Mugadil. If I already feel your anointing and your peace in this place tonight, Mugadil. Akana, Mugadil, Kirchi, Buchiad, Mugadil. If I pray tonight, Deva, in Jesus' name, Mugadil, that you, Mugadil, will teach us your word, Mugadil. Deva, without the Holy Spirit, Mugadil, it is impossible, Mugadil. So we ask, Deva, Akana, Mugadil. Touch our hearts, Mugadil. And Lord, I pray tonight, Mugadil, in Jesus' name, that we will examine ourselves, Mugadil, and our walk through, Mugadil, that we could be that witness, Mugadil, that you call us to be, Mugadil. In Jesus' name I pray, amen and amen. The past couple weeks, the gentleman has been teaching and been doing a beautiful job. And Holy Spirit, prayer, worship, we talked about the gift of Shiva, Uncle Johnny. And then the boys talked about Christian.
Yeah.
So we're trying to follow up on the criteria of what we've been going on. Because basically all we've been talking about is being a Christian, which is being Christ-like,
amen,
which is following Christ. And when the pastor asked me last week, Jacare, would you saw for next week? The moment he said that, God already gave me the word. We're going to talk about witnessing.
Wow.
Witnessing. Janas. Because of Christo Mopo Trusu.
And making a way for our after events to be made.
And the reason why Halalas of Scuppy made because the word of God went out. It was by his witness, by his testimony, that the word of God goes forth that we can receive salvation. The witness began 2,000 years ago, John. And that, we're going to two areas over here. I want to talk about the Christian who's the faithful witness. If I'm telling you, if you are a faithful witness, you will receive a crown of righteousness. And there's a Christian who's not faithful, the unfaithful Christian, and he's going to have to answer to God for lost souls.
Wow.
So with that, we're going to get serious tonight about witnessing, because in my body, what she said. Madhubote Haran, Manus Gindin, Chisim Rasai, Chisim Elder, Chisim Deacon, Chikirapuchi in the Kangari, I don't have to do it. But Matasimundi, you have the biggest title that you could ever have.
Sure.
It's not the title of a pastor, or an elder, or a deacon, or a servant. The title that you have is a Christian.
Amen.
And this is your responsibility. At that, I'm going to show you the flip side of the coin. The faithful Christian receives a crown of righteousness. The unfaithful Christian is going to have to answer to God for lost souls. Because tonight, the teaching is called witnessing and winning souls. How that's done. Christians who are not faithful will have to answer to God for lost souls to whom they fail to witness to. Ecclesiastes 12:14 talks about, for God will bring every deed into judgment, whether it's good, whether it's bad. One day, we will all come before God, and we'll have to answer for the good or for the bad. This is for the believer, for the non-believer. This is for the Christian, for the Catholic, whatever it is, we're all going to come before God. We know that the faithful Christians will receive a reward. Now, I want to show you something, what the Spirit of the Lord revealed to me. It's not a new revelation.
Okay.
It's something that was always there, but it's been revealed to me, and I want to share it with you. We know when we come before God, if I'm telling you that we're going to see rewards and crowns for our good deeds. And when we come before God, we know that Avasana the state, we're going to take off that crown and shoot us under the state, because he's the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords.
Amen.
But I found the scripture in Malachi 3:17, and Matope, and they shall be mine, says the Lord of hosts, on that day that I make them my jewels. Another translation says, treasure.
And I don't want to tell you that you are his jewels. You are the treasure of God. And when that day comes, we come before the Lord, John, we're not going to take off crowns and throw the crown at his feet. The Bible says that you're the jewel. We're going to throw ourselves at his feet. Because we're his jewel. Amen?
Isaiah 54:13, Matominga.
All the children which are made, will be taught by the Lord.
All right, so what does that mean? We understand that we're going to be taught by the Lord. The word taught in another translation means teach. And that word means instruction, training, to prepare, to pass down what you have learned, to develop a process of time, and also in doctrine. Doctrine means sound teaching, we know that. The Holy Spirit will train you, develop you, to become the witness that He wants us to be.
Amen.
Now, I'm going to ask you a two-part question because this is a Bible study,
and I expect to get answers about them tonight. I just don't want to stand here without doing what I'm dying now. The main thing is we need to receive something tonight.
Amen.
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 Who? One question, one. Who's the greatest witness?
Jesus.
No more answer, everybody will say Jesus. But that's not the right answer. The greatest witness is the Holy Spirit.
Come on.
Why? It's the Holy Spirit of God that bears witness that Jesus is the Son of God. It's the Holy Spirit that bears witness to prove evidence that this is the Son of God.
Amen.
Naturally, Jesus, Son of God, is a great witness. But he did his witness that you have to prove. What did he walk upon the earth? His ministry 3 years, Nikki? The Holy Spirit is still doing his work. The Holy Spirit is still being that great witness. The Holy Spirit is still demonstrating, still proving that he is the Son of God. And it's by the Word of God, by that testimony, that people can receive salvation today. Amen? Now,
let me explain to you how important the witness is. I said this before, and I'm going to say it again.
Obanuska chisano de vis. Can I scope me? I am Jonas.
When that person looks upon you, what witness is he going to see? Because you might be the closest thing to God he may ever see.
100%.
He has to see God through you in order for him to receive the word.
Okay.
The word to be implanted, the goal shall be made. The question tonight, how is your witness? You have to understand, we are Christians, Christiana. We have an obligation. We have a duty and a will to be Christ-like, to be that witness. I'll ask you again tonight.
What does the word witness mean? Throw them out, you guys. Come on. What does the word witness mean?
Going out there.
Preaching the word. Dying for Christ.
Dying for Christ.
Example.
Christ-like. Come on. Throw them out there. We're looking at the word witness.
Living for Christ.
Living for Christ. Keep coming.
Going to people's houses.
The word witness means one that gives evidence.
Say it again.
One that gives evidence to testify, a testimony, serving as evidence or a proof. The word witness means confirmation.
Very good.
It means knowledge.
Confirmation, very good.
That's witness. We need to be that witness. We need to be the witness that God called us to be. Amen? Ibam Atoming in Psalms 51:13.
Very good.
Then I will teach your ways,
and sinners will be converted to you. You see, the whole purpose about being a Christian is to save a soul, Pastor. What good is it that thou hast done for wisdom, I will now ask you, and I will see. But our witness is not good enough to save a soul. Well, we're going to have to answer the doctor.
100.
You don't have to be a pastor. You don't have to be an elder. You don't have to be a servant, a teacher, a choir member. You have to be a Christian. And there is a divine called accountability.
Archie, what was that Psalms?
That's Psalms 51:13. Sinners shall be converted to you. That's called soul winning. The whole purpose of Christianity is to save a soul.
It's the Holy Spirit's job to bear witness who is the Son of God, and it's our job also to bear witness to bring people to God.
Sure.
It's a hand in hand. We have a responsibility. Now, the word converted means to turn back. It also means to return back to the starting point. It means to go again. Now, I always say this, I'll say it again. God is not a God of a second chance. God is a God of another chance.
Great word.
We're going to fall. Got off mistakes. Bit off. But get back up. Get back up.
Very good. Chance.
Has your witness been too kadosh? Has your witness been damaged?
Because that muscle that wasn't fulfilled and that witness is demolished. Because I'll tell you something what I learned.
All the goodness that you're going to do, you make one mistake, go on to a testimony. Go on, so. No matter what you do, you're the armor bearer. You're the man of God. One mistake, go to testimony.
Done.
Well, Ibrahim Akominga, start, go back to the starting point. Do it again. Get back up and become that witness that God wants us to be. Amen?
Amen.
I want to look at four different types of witnesses. And I'm going to try my best to explain to you four different types of witnessing. The first one is called prescribable.
Hmm.
When I found this word, John,
what does it mean?
Prescribable.
Prescribable.
And I looked at the word, and I found the word throughout most of the Old Testament. And the word means washed.
Uh-huh.
The word means testimony. Okay? I found a scripture that goes to the 1 Samuel 10:8. The Metope, to lay down as guide or role of an action. Now what? What does this mean? And then I got it. This is what the word means. Speaking the word of God to people who ask you.
Don't ask me how I found it. I have no idea.
Speaking the word of God to people who ask you. Now, here's where the accountability comes back into play. Now, listen to this very carefully. What does that scripture mean? The abomination of the desolation, and they're going to run the mouth and eat scroll for 4 years. What does that mean? I'm just adding on. Oh, do you want us to... The manus mato, if chijanes will answer, if you don't know the answer, and a manus maton chijanah, humbly, I can't answer it, you're not accountable for it. You will not be charged for it. But here's the scary part. Let's say you know the answer.
Wow.
You know the answer. And do matos. So you thought, I don't want to hurt this guy. I don't want to hurt his feelings. You just, I won't say too strong a word, you just held back God's word. If I were to speak the word with boldness, with authority, without holding back, this is something I've done, and this is your witness. Your witness is, I'm a man of God, and we need to know the word of God, and we need to speak the word of God, we need to teach the word of God, and we need to do it with boldness and with authority. Don't hold back God's word, because it's not our word, it's His word.
Hallelujah.
If God gave you the word, speak the word of God.
Amen.
If you don't know it, there's no accountability.
Sure.
She's an out. Let me look into it. Ask someone else. So one, much is given, much is required. All right, that's number one.
Good word, Archie.
Amen. Number two, we're talking about witnessing. This word is example. The example of your testimony. Your testimony is supposed to be an example.
Sure.
The way you live, the way you talk, the way you dress,
saw this,
it's an example. So, your testimony is, Chodivano,
Your testimony, your witness is your example. Okay? Psalms 119:46. I will speak of your testimony before kings and not be ashamed. I delight myself in your commandments, which I love.
It's a big
thing. Okay. Supernatural is a big thing. Your witness is the way you live,
sure,
the way you act, the way you talk, and your example of what Christ done on this earth. That's an example. Number three, you need to be a living witness. Are we living the witness of now adult the cross?
Karas if we're cheap for giant, but now adult the cross. Or are we about to become a living? I'll speak for myself.
I can come in church in my holy suit, and I guarantee every one of you is here, I can fool you.
I can make you think that I'm a spiritual man, I'm a man of God. Lord, don't say it to Lord, Ujima, hey, let's pray, brother, it's all good. But how's my living witness when those triggers are shut, job cut up, the way I act, the way I talk, my job, so cut up.
We need to be a living witness. Not only in the pulpit, not only in the church, not only in the Bible studies, but our everyday lifestyle. That's the living witness. How does that happen? That's only by a divine help. That witness comes by a divine help. Now I'll explain to you what that is. A divine help is God, read it, supernatural meanings by God, communication to His Word. Let's look at Revelation chapter 2. Now this is the revelation of Jesus. This is His testimony. To His servant John, who bore witness to the Word of God and the testimony of Jesus Christ to the things that he saw. Now what is that? That's an eyewitness. That's an eyewitness. He's seen the things that Fanel built. He's seen Fanel built.
Are we that eyewitness?
Wow. Now, let me explain to you in today's terms what is an eyewitness. Who's seen the miracle of God? Raise your hand. Amen. Do you know what a miracle is? A miracle defies the laws of nature. That's what miracle means.
There's no, it goes against Sofanel and Yehina Sikras. It defies the law of nature. That's a miracle.
Well, we're living witnesses to miracles.
We've seen people be healed. We've seen people have ministry to be made.
Well, they'll never accept the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
To them, I went witnessing to them, but they, I tried. It's on God's time.
Amen. But we're eyewitnesses to those miracles, and that's an eyewitness. Everybody in this church is an eyewitness.
Amen.
Amen.
Last one. I won't keep you long.
Preacher.
A false witness.
This is what a charge comes against you. Against me, against the Christian.
You have to understand, I'm not talking about the witness. Okay, Saturday night, 4 or 5 guys, Jason in New York, we'll stop at this guy's house, this guy's house.
I'm not talking about that kind of thing.
Sure.
And here's the point, though. I'm lacking in that area. Witness needs to be done.
Me too.
Seek it out.
We need to all work in that area to go out to save a soul.
Right, I like it too.
We're lacking in that area. We need to pray that the witness may
grow up, to give us the strength and the ability to be the witness of God, to be that living testimony, to be that eyewitness, because that's the ability to achieve.
But I want to talk now about a false witness. Why am I going to a false witness now? Because Uncle Johnny's got a word that's going to go way into this.
I know Uncle Johnny's got a word from the Lord tonight. A false witness. Here's what it is.
Falsehood. False brotherhood. Lying, slander, a false witness is a false worshiper, false teachers, error, a delusional spirit.
Okay.
And what does it say in Exodus 20:16?
Thou shalt not bear false witness. I'm not giving you a solution tonight.
I'm just leaving your mind wander. Let the Holy Spirit speak to you. How is your witness? How's our witness, Nikki? Are we doing something now, Bill? What's the Great Commission? What is it, Nick?
Go out and preach the gospel, teach the word.
And how we do that? Witnessing. Saving souls. Speaking the word of God. God called us to be a true witness. And let me tell you what a true witness does. He saves lost souls.
If we're missing that whole point in our Christianity, then we're failing. If we're not going out to save a soul, if we're not going out, then we're going to answer to God. We're going to answer to God. We're going to have to answer to God.
You're right, Lord.
At that, we pray, let's seek the Lord, and let's examine ourselves.
Amen.
Don't let no one examine you, Nikki. Don't let no one examine you, Bobby.
Examine yourself. And that's God. Devil, I'm lacking in this area.
I'm missing the mark. She cut out, so for that, she cut out.
I'm sorry, cut out, she for she. And you know what's going to happen? Then you will be that living witness.
Amen.
Then you will be that man of God that will put out Bill.
The whole purpose of witnessing is to save a soul. Amen?
Amen.
God bless you.